Hello everyone, I'm BJ, and today we're going to be talking about succulents. I am a mad fan of succulents, and I've been collecting them for about 20 years. It delighted me so much when they became all the rage at all the garden centers because all of a sudden the availability of varieties became wider. A lot of new ones came on the market and people really put a lot of focus on dedicating some bench space to them. So they became a lot easier for me to find. And I'm always amazed. I grow a lot of them at my house under my Happy Leaf Pro lights. And I'm always really amazed on how different my plants look under those lights versus the same plants of the same crop grown in a commercial greenhouse where I work. A lot of times they are just bigger and more robust. The coloration is often a lot different. So when we got 50 new unrooted succulent cuttings in the end of October, I got a big brain idea that I really wanted to test out the effects of light on these succulents. So in conducting this trial, the number one thing that I was really looking at was coloration, because there can be a really wide variety of color depending on the kind of light it's exposed to, as I see between my plants at home versus the greenhouse. We have plants, there's a Echeveria blue elf that under really good lights really looks blue. In a commercial greenhouse looks kind of pale green. There's red coral reef that really looks like red coral reef when you have it under a good light, but not so much under not. So I chose varieties that I thought would display different colorations primarily. Secondly, as I mentioned earlier, we got these in as unrooted cuttings, so they had no roots on them. And I wanted to know if growing them under lights or different types of lights would speed up growth and therefore have those plants root faster. Because the faster you can get unrooted cuttings of any kind rooted, the healthier the plant's going to be. They have less time to succumb to rot and things like that. And then lastly, I just wanted to look at overall health, vigor, and growth of the top parts of the plant, regardless of coloring. So those are the three primary things I was looking at with an emphasis on coloration. So from here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take out individual plants so that you can see them side by side with what type of light I grew them under, because I think in this case, a picture really is worth a thousand words. So we'll get some side by sides between the greenhouse, the white LED lights, the Happy Leaf Pro, and then our test light in our lab at Happy Leaf. Okay, so the first plant that we're going to feature is an aeonium called Kiwi Verde. This is the one that was grown in the greenhouse. Then we have the white LED. Then we have the Procyon Pro. And then the test light with the UV. You can see on the Procyon Pro how much new growth and babies it's putting off here. That's wonderful. This plant is going to bush out much faster. And I'm pretty happy with these results. Look at the red tips on this one versus next to nothing on this one and absolutely nothing on this one. So in this case, the coloration really did improve under the pro light, and it's also a much healthier, more robust plant. Okay, so this one here is an Echeveria shaviana is the species, which is just really fun to say. And I love the class of Echeverias. They're usually rosette shaped. I have some at home that are really, really huge and beautiful under my lights. But again, greenhouse grown, white light, Happy Leaf Pro lights, and then our test light. And the difference is just really incredible. I mean, and this is being grown in a commercial greenhouse. The coloration is completely different. The size is different. This one checked all the boxes for what I was looking for in the experiment. So that one's a really great plant and a really good example of the difference that you have. Okay, so this one is Echeveria Coral Reef Red. This one can get really large, and it really does look like it belongs under the sea. It's one of my very favorite ones. But both here and at home, it's one of the ones I have been observing at my own house. Really great pink coloration on the edges, and it's also wavier, which was a side benefit I wasn't expecting under the lights. But my one at home really is a quite large one. It's in a 2-gallon pot and it's a single rosette. But you can't see the pink edging hardly at all unless it's under a good light. So
definitely for this particular variety, the quality of light means everything when it comes to the quality of the plant. Okay, this is an interesting plant. Somebody brought into us a cutting. It is called Athano Ruby Necklace, which I think is an adorable name, but some really stunning differences in this one as far as coloration goes. It's one that we have, it takes a little bit longer for us to root. So I really think the benefits are awesome with this one because usually when you have the bigger, more robust tops, you're going to have healthier, more robust roots. And again, remember, the faster you can get cuttings to root, the better off you are because they have a high chance of rotting off in between sticking them and actually forming roots. So again, another really great coloration. This one's almost black. It's so deep purple. This one's got a little bit of a mix. And then these ones are pretty straight up green with the purple. It's maintained the purple stems, but the leaves aren't purple at all. So a really great demonstration of the changes that good quality lights can do to the coloration of your plants. And this one here is Calancho Gastanus. And I wanted to show you this one because this is what I was talking about. Where you really want to get them rooted as quickly as possible. And in this case, the one under the white LED did not root, and it ended up rotting out. So that's why it has no color at all, because it's not even rooted. But again, some pretty great differences. Much more heavily spotted on the Happy Leaf Pro Light, and certainly more vigorous and bigger. Those are just some of the examples of the 32 that I tested. So high quality light really is the difference between surviving plants and thriving plants. Please like us on Facebook, subscribe to our YouTube channel, share this video with all your other succulent loving buddies, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for joining.